Now we, I welcome Professor Dr. Bernard Lobel. He's a urologist and a former chief doctor at the Hospital of Rennes in France.
Finally, the urologist comes. I would like to ask to the Member of Parliament of Iceland not to ban circumcision. Why? So many countries by the past, through the century, tried to ban circumcision, and circumcision remains. I would say that the last one was the Soviet Union. We spoke about it, and we know that the Soviet Union collapsed and the circumcision remained. So, I understand the fears your previous speaker spoke about. That's not the reality. And you understood, first of all, what was circumcision. We have seen that perfectly. And the second point, we have understood how much it's important for the religious people. So, I would like to emphasize about two points. First of all, is circumcision a mutilation? And I have many argumentations. It's not a mutilation. To remove a small part of skin and mucosa in excess is not a mutilation. And the first argument is a statistical argument. If you follow the World Health Organization, they claim that all over the world, more than 700 million males are circumcised. Are they mutilated? In the States, 50 to 60% of American males are circumcised. In Israel, 98% of the male population is circumcised. They are not mutilated. The second argument is the argument of a urologist. As a urologist, I had to perform some circumcision in adults. And in adults, when you do that, you don't have the feeling to mutilate the patient. But in the contrary, when you have a penile cancer, you have to remove the glands. This is a terrible, awful mutilation. The third argument is a surgical argument. Some men are born with a small penis, which is called micropenis. It's terrible, it's less than 5 centimeters in erection in adult. And it's a possibility now to reconstruct the penis. So if you want to reconstruct the penis, it's a difficult operation. It takes 8 hours, but it's a possibility. So you can take a graft of skin on the arm with the vessel and the nerves, and you reconstruct the penis. Even the glands, the aesthetical aspect is perfect, but it's not functional, sexually speaking, because it's like skin. It has no feeling. If you want to keep the special sensitivity of the penis, you have to keep the micropenis, and the glands of the micropenis comes at the root of the new reconstructed penis. Moreover, and that's the last argument, the Danish Pediatrician Association said a few years ago that when you perform a circumcision for therapeutic reason, it's not a mutilation. But if you do it for religious purpose, that's become a mutilation. As a surgeon, I knew that when I cut an arm or a leg, whatever is the reason, It's a real mutilation. The second point is, does circumcision change sexuality? So it's a difficult point, because if you do circumcision in childhood, it's difficult to know if it was different before and after. But you can have the trial on adults. And when you speak with the adults before and after the circumcision, you can see that it's not different. Yeah, the sensitivity is different, but the quality is the same. But you have to wait a little bit, because in adults, after the circumcision, the trouble is for a long time, which means many months. And that's an advice I give to Mrs. Nordahl and Mr. Gunnarsson. If they have a child to be circumcised, it's better to do it in childhood than in adult, because in adult, it's much more traumatic. So, we have seen that circumcision has advantages and disadvantages. Advantages, we have seen already, that's in terms of decreasing the risk for, partially decreasing the risk of AIDS and STD. It's more hygienic, is any, we have seen all the reasons. But disadvantages are very low. It's a low-risk operation. So finally, in conclusion, I would say that I agree that it's a fight in between the right for the people to have their own religion, the right for the parents to raise the children as they want, and the necessity to protect the physical integrity of childhood. But in conclusion, what I would say, don't ban the circumcision. Why? Because if you ban it, you will push the circumcision into clandestinity. And if you push into clandestinity, it's not the best way to protect physical integrity of the children. I thank you.